Hello everyone, welcome to my lecture number 3 on pointers. In this lecture, I am going to explain how to pass pointers as arguments to function. So all of you know that when we are using the function in C program, we have to pass different types of arguments to function. We can pass normal variables as arguments, we can pass array as argument, we can pass structure as argument. Now we will pass pointers as argument. The important thing while passing the pointers as argument is that we are passing address of variable as argument to the function. So while passing the pointer, actually the address of variable is passed as argument to the function, and hence this type of passing of argument is also known as passing by reference or call by reference. The reference indicates the reference to value, means the address. So this passing by reference or call by reference is also called as passing by address or call by address, as we are passing the address of variable as argument to the function. Now let us see how to specify the pointer as formal arguments in function definition. So in function definition, the pointer is specified as formal arguments like this. So this is the general format or the syntax of passing pointer to function. So this is the first line of function definition. As usual, this is the return type, that is the data type of the return value of the function. Function name. In the formal argument, you have to declare the pointer. In lecture 1, we have seen how to declare the pointer. The same step you have to write here, data type star ptr. So like this here, in function definition, the formal argument is specified in this way. Let us see one example, void swap. Swap is a function which returns no value, that is a void function. It has two arguments as two pointers. First is px and the second argument is py. So here, as this px and py are preceded by asterisk or star, they are considered as pointer. Then while calling the function, in function call, how to specify the pointer as actual argument? This is the format. Specify the function name, and in the parenthesis you have to specify the address of the variable. So this address of the variable is to be specified. For example, swap is the function and there are two addresses we are passing. One is ampersand x, ampersand y, that is address of x and address of y. So like this, in function definition, you have to declare the pointer variable as formal argument, while in function call, we have to pass the address of actual variable as argument. Now, let us apply this concept in a program. So, using this concept, I will write a program. Now, let us see how to write a program using pointers to function. So, here is one sample program. Program to swap two variables using pointer to function. So, let us write first function definition and followed by the main function. So I will write the function definition to swap two variables using pointer. The name of function is swap. The return type is void. There are two arguments. Both arguments are pointers. first pointer, first argument is pointer px, second argument is pointer py. So as we studied in the theory that here you have to write the declaration of pointer. Now using this pointer, I will write the steps to swap the values in terms of pointer. Again, for swapping, I require one temporary variable. So let us temp is one local variable of this in this function. The first step is temp is equal to star px. Star px is equal to star py. Star py is equal to temp. Again, in these three steps, instead of using direct variables x and y, I am using here pointer to x, that is star px, and pointer to y, that is star py. So in terms of px and py, I am writing these steps to swap the values of variables which are pointed by px and py. As this is a void function, it will not return anything. So this is the function definition to swap two variables using pointers. Let us go for main function. In main function, I will require two integer variables, that is x and y. Next, I have accepted the values of variable x and variable y. Let us see, I entered the value of x as 15 and value of y as 20. Then I will print the values of x and y before swapping. In this way, the value of x will be printed as 15 and value of y is printed as 20. Then I will call here the swap function, the swap with two actual arguments. Now here actual arguments are address of x and address of y. So in the function call, as we learned that the addresses are passed to the function. So this is our function call using function. So the address of variable x, address of variable y is passed to the swap function. Now this swap function will be called and the values of variable x and y will be swapped. After that, I will display the values after swapping, that is value of x and y. I will get the value of x as 20 and value of y as 50. Let us understand with the help of diagram. In the memory, the variable x will be created having value 15. Variable y will be created having value 20. These are the addresses of x and y, which are assigned to pointer px and pointer py. Whenever this function is called swap ampersand x ampersand y, the control of program is transferred here to the function, and the first formal argument, that is px, will be initialized with the first actual argument ampersand x. In this way, the address of x is assigned to px, and in this diagram you can see the px will become the pointer of x. Secondly, the address of y is assigned to py. So here the py will become the pointer of y. So like this, in the function call, px will become the pointer of x and py will become the pointer of y. Then in this step, temp is equal to star px. So the value of star px, what is the star value of star px? The value pointed by px. So here star px means the value pointed by px. The value pointed by px is 15, that is assigned to temp variable. So here in first step, 15 will be stored in the variable temp. Second step, star px is equal to star py means the value pointed by py will be stored as value pointed by px. So value pointed by py is 20, which is stored in value pointed by variable pointed by py, the variable pointed by px. The variable pointed by px is 15 x. So previous value of 15 will be replaced with the value of y, that is 20, in terms of py. third step is the value of temp variable is stored in the variable pointed by py. The variable pointed by py is y. The value of temp is 15, and in this way this value of temp will be stored in y. In this way this 20 will be replaced with 15. Now you can see here the value of x and y are swapped or exchanged. The 15 is replaced with 20, which is the value of y, and 20 is replaced with the value 15, which is the value of x. So in this way, here the value of variable x and value of variable y are swapped using pointers px and py. And like this, we are getting the output here, x is equal to 20 and y is equal to 15. As in this program, we are passing the address, not the value, to this function. So this is the function by passing address or passing by reference. So px and py, these are indirectly operating on x and y, and the value of x, that is x and y, these variables are not directly involved in this particular function for swapping. In the function, the pointer px and pointer py are involved, which are indirectly operating on x and y. X and y, these variables are in the scope of the main function. And in this way, through function, the value of x and y are swapped indirectly using pointer px and py. So that is the benefit of the passing pointer to function, that instead of passing direct value to the function, we can pass the address of variables to the function, and using pointers we can access the value of variables indirectly. So that is the main advantage of this pointers passing to function, that is the indirect access of variables within the memory. So this program clearly demonstrates the how to pass the pointers to function. Thank you.